Okay, let's practice some MCQ related to antiviral. And the first question is, what is the mechanism of action of nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor? And to answer this question, we should know the what are the mechanism of different antiretroviral drugs. First, we according to the first aid, we have five category of drugs. See, the first drug is the fusion inhibitors or fusion inhibitors. In this, the first drug is maraviroc, which inhibits the attachment. First, it attachment with viral attachment with T lymphocyte. So it binds with this maraviroc binds with the CCR5 and inhibit interaction with viral GP120. The second group of drug is infubiltide, and infubiltide is penetration or fusion inhibitor. As its name contains FU, it means it is a fusion inhibitor, and it binds to the GP41. The once virus enters into the body, it gets uncoated, and then the viral RNA is converted into the DNA with the help of enzyme known as reverse transcriptase. So the main drug in HIV is the drugs that inhibit reverse transcriptase, and we have two category of drug: nucleoside reverse transcriptase and non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase. Nucleoside reverse transcriptase are the competitive inhibitors, and non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase are non-competitive inhibitors. Nucleosides reverse transcriptase (NRTI) requires phosphorylation before they act, and NNRTI does not require phosphorylation. These two are the main difference. NRTI, the mechanism of NRTI, the common drugs are gedobudine, stabudine, lamivudine, didunosine, abacavir. Okay, the second and non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor is ibavirenz, nevirapine, delaviridine. Among the all the NRTI, only tenofovir, T means only tenofovir is nucleotide, and all other are nucleoside. So NRTI means nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor, not nucleotide reverse transcriptase inhibitor. Once it get converted into double bond, it can converted into DNA, it get integrated into the human DNA with the help of enzyme known as integrase. So the next group of drug will be integrase inhibitor, and this includes the drug like dolutegravir, elvitegravir, raltegravir. After incorporation, it started to form mRNA, and those mRNA changed into functional protein and packaging with the help of enzyme protease. So the next group of drug is protease inhibitor, and this includes the drugs whose name ends with navir, and these include darunavir, indinavir, lopinavir, ritonavir, esquinavir. And if you compare the other virus with HIV, only we have to remember the drug. Once the virus enters into the human cell, it gets uncoated, and the uncoating is prevented by the drugs like amantadine and remantadine, no longer used for influenza due to increased resistance. And after uncoating, the virus nucleic acid synthesized, and viral nucleic acid synthesis inhibited by drugs like guanosine analog, acyclovir, ganciclovir, viral DNA polymerase inhibitor like cidofovir, foscarnate, and guanine nucleoside synthesis inhibitor like ribavirin. Once the viral get assembled, it get released outside of the body and outside of the cell, and this is inhibited by neuraminidase inhibitors like oseltamivir and zanamivir. Now back to the question, mechanism of action of NRTI. So it is competitively inhibit nucleotide binding to the reverse transcriptase. This will be the answer. Non-competitive binding is by the NNRTI. Reversibly inhibit the HIV integrase by the integrase inhibitor, and block CCR5 is maraviroc. Okay, next question. If you focus on this, what is HART? That is highly active antiretroviral therapy. So what do we call what is HART? HART consists of three drugs, that is two NRTI and one NNRTI only. So this will be the answer. The next, which of the following drug is used to treat Kaposi sarcoma? So to answer this, we should know about interferon. Interferons are the glycoproteins normally synthesized by the virus infected cells and exhibiting a wide range of antiviral and anti-tumoral properties. And we have alpha, interferon alpha, interferon beta and interferon gamma. So starting from lower, interferon gamma used in the chronic granulomatous disease, interferon beta used in the multiple sclerosis, and in any other condition interferon alpha is used. So interferon alpha is used in the condition like chronic hepatitis C, chronic hepatitis B, Kaposi sarcoma, hairy cell leukemia, condyloma acuminata, renal cell carcinoma and malignant melanoma. Next, which of the following antiviral drug causes the renal wasting of magnesium? So which drug causes the renal wasting of magnesium? Just guess. So we have to remember the side effect of the all the drugs given here. The acyclovir, all of the drugs can cause the renal toxicity. So acyclovir causes the obstructive crystalline nephropathy and acute renal failure. Main side effect of acyclovir is obstructive crystalline nephropathy. The main side effect of foscarnet is also nephrotoxicity, and it can cause electrolyte abnormalities like hypo or hyperphosphatemia, hypokalemia and hypomagnesemia. Next is the zanamivir, we don't need to read. Ganciclovir, the main side effect of ganciclovir is bone marrow suppression that can lead to the leukopenia, neutropenia, thrombocytopenia and renal toxicity. So the common side effect to the all antiviral drug is renal toxicity. So it should be administered with a lot of water, IV fluid. What is the mechanism of action of integrase inhibitor? Mechanism of action of integrase inhibitor is obviously it inhibit the integrase. So it reversibly inhibit the HIV integrase, which prevent the HIV genome integration into the host cells. Next, which of the following is integrase inhibitor? So which drug inhibit the integrase? Nabirapine is NNRTI. Lopinavir, all the navirs are protease inhibitors. Raltegravir, gravirs are integrase inhibitor. Maraviroc is the CCR5 inhibitor. And tenofovir is NRTI. Next, CDC recommendation for HIV mother is, when should the HIV patient should take drugs in case of pregnancy? It is judobidine at 14 week of gestation and continue throughout the pregnancy. Next, what is the mechanism of action of NNRTI? It is non-competitive. Non-competitively bind to the reverse transcriptase inhibitor and terminate the DNA chain. Next, which of the following drug is used to treat multiple sclerosis? It is interferon beta. Next, which of the following drug is used to treat HSV and varicella zoster virus? Both is treated with acyclovir. Next, which of the following is side effect of didanosine? So we should know what are the side effect. So we should know the side effect of the all the HIV drugs, HIV related drug. It is didanosine, the main side effect is pancreatitis. Next, what is the mechanism of action of ribavirin? And ribavirin act by inhibiting the IMP dehydrogenase, and it is used in treatment of hepatitis C and respiratory syncytial virus. Next, which of the following drug is nephrotoxicity? All the antiviral drug have nephrotoxic effect, and answer will be acyclovir. Next, which of the following is protease inhibitor? All navirs are protease inhibitor, so lopinavir. Next, which of the following blocks CCR5 on surface of T cell or monocyte? Which of the following blocks CCR5? It answer will be maraviroc. Next, CDC recommendation for infant born of HIV mother. So the answer will be oral administration of judobidine in infant for the 6 weeks. Next, what is the mechanism of action of protease inhibitor? So obviously it will inhibit the HIV protease. Next, which of the following is side effect of raltegravir? So the side effect of raltegravir is the main integrase inhibitors has common side effect, that is the it increases the protein creatinine kinase according to Foster, and the answer will be hypercholesterolemia. So what are the other side effect of the drugs related to HIV? If you consider judobidine, the main side effect is hematotoxicity, and it can cause bone marrow suppression. That is, it can lead to the anemia, thrombocytopenia, leukopenia. So it should not be given in the patient patient having anemia. Didanosine, main side effect is pancreatitis. Stuvobidine, peripheral neuropathy. Lamivudine, it is less toxic than NRTI. Next question. Which of the following drug is used to treat chronic granulomatous disease? It is obviously interferon gamma. Next, which of the following drug is used to treat acyclovir-resistant HSV? Acyclovir-resistant HSV should be treated with a drug called foscarnet. Next, which of the following can cause leukopenia, neutropenia and thrombocytopenia? It is ganciclovir, which is used to treat cytomegalovirus. In case of cytomegalovirus, acyclovir, valacyclovir, other antivirals are not effective. Only the ganciclovir is effective. Which of the following drug is used in the prevention of influenza A? And it is, which drug used in prevention? It is oseltamivir or zanamivir. These drugs inhibit influenzal neuraminidase and inhibit the release of progeny viruses. And the therapy should be begun within the 48 hours of the symptom onset. Next, which of the following drug is used to treat hepatitis B and hepatitis C? It is obviously interferon alpha. Next, what is the mechanism of action of acyclovir? So it is acyclovir. What does it does? Acyclovir is guanosine analog. It gets first monophosphorylated by the HSV thymidine kinase and not phosphorylated in uninfected cells. So it has very few side effects. It only attack infected cells. And the mechanism of action is it inhibits DNA polymerase chain termination. Next, which of the following inhibit the influenza neuraminidase, decreasing release of progeny virus? Obviously, answer will be Oseltamivir, that is Tamiflu. Next, which of the following antiviral drug can cause crystalline nephropathy? It is acyclovir. Next, which of the following drug is used to treat chronic hepatitis C? We have three drugs which is used to treat hepatitis C. It is ribavirin, one, sofosbuvir, second, and simprevir is the third. Next, which of the following drug is used to treat CMV? Yes, that is ganciclovir. Which of the following drug is used to prevent fetal transmission of HIV from the infected mother? Obviously, judobidine. Next, all of the following drugs are teratogenic except, we know it is amoxicillin. Tetracycline can cause discoloration of teeth and inhibition of bone growth. Chloramphenicol can cause gray baby syndrome. Ribavirin is teratogenic. Fluoroquinolone can cause cartilage damage. Clarithromycin is embryo toxic. Sulfonamide can cause carnic teres. Grisophalbin, embryo toxic. Ibavirin, toxic. So the answer will be, what is the answer? Amoxicillin. Next, what is the mechanism of action of enfuvirtide, that is fusion inhibitor? Enfuvirtide will bind to the GP41 and inhibit penetration of the virus. Next, all of the following are the side effect of indinavir, protease inhibitors. And the protease inhibitor, which of the following is a side, which is not a side effect of protease inhibitor? So protease inhibitors are those drugs which ends with navir in the end. And the protease inhibitors, how I have remembered the protease inhibitors, navirs, like इंडिनाविर्स, लोपिनाविर्स, रिटोनाविर्स एंड सिक्विनाविर्स, लाइक इंडिया, इंडिनाविर्स, नेपाल एंड एल्विनाविर्स, एंड दे हैव ब्रेड रिलेशन, दैट इज रोटी नबीर एंड दारू नबीर एंड सेक्वा नबीर, दैट इज सेक्वा मीन्स सेक्विनाविर, एंड व्हेन यू ईट ऑल दिस थिंग्स एंड यू विल गेट साइड इफेक्ट लाइक हाइपरग्लाइसेमिया, जीआई इंटॉलरेंस, लाइपोडिस्ट्रॉफी, लाइक कुशिंग लाइक सिंड्रोम्स, एंड स्पेशली विद इंडिनाविर, इंडिनाविर इट कैन कॉज नेफ्रोपैथी, हेमाचूरिया एंड थ्रोम्बोसाइटोपेनिया. So the all are the side effect except pancreatitis. Which of the following is non-nucleotide reverse transcriptase inhibitor? That is nevirapine.